So I have never felt heartbreak the way I did when Justice Winslow was injured last season for Miami and missed pretty much the entire season, only playing like 20-something games. But I think going into this upcoming season, I think he could be one of the five Eastern Conference players in this video today who could really take off next season. And with Winslow, I mean, immediately there's the defense. The dude's a freaking brick wall. Like, it's actually a little weird how NBA ready he was from like a strength standpoint at like 18 years old. The guy might have been lifting weights when he was like 11, I don't know. But he seems like a guy who can defend NBA point guards through potentially some power forwards. He really is that gifted on the defensive side of the floor. And it helps when the guy running the whole operation for Miami, Pat Riley, has said that Winslow is the franchise centerpiece of these guys. And what was really interesting in like the 20 games he played this year was his development offensively with the ball in his hands. He was a guy who, like, you could actually run some offense through. He got to, I want to say, over 3 assists a game while also being someone who could be in pick and rolls and grab a rebound and then take the ball down floor himself, potentially finish at the rim. And I think he's just going to expand on that in his third season, because on top of just improvement, like, we didn't really get to see him flourish in his second year because, once again, he was only in there for, what, maybe 2 months tops? And I think just the natural progression for Winslow, his third season, it's going to be awesome. I think when I look at him right now, I see like an Andre Iguodala with just everything he can do besides shooting, and then hopefully the shooting can come around. But even if he doesn't develop that right away or whatever, I think he can be a super impactful player for the Miami Heat starting next season. Next, we're going to head to the Boston Celtics, Avery Bradley. Now, Bradley was surprising me a bit this season because, you know, he was always a guy who was like a spot shooter, and he made a lot of improvements there. He's become a legitimate offensive player. But to start this season, you could see that he was working on his ball handling and his ability to create his own offense, because he was actually beating guys off the dribble to start out this year for the Celtics. And it just seemed like he was going to add like another real piece to his offensive repertoire. But the problem was he was injured for about 2 months, and then ever since he's come back, he really hasn't been too confident in his ability to attack guys one-on-one. And I think going into next season, a perfectly healthy Avery Bradley, he could be more willing to attack guys. And as a result, I mean, who knows what his offensive limitations really are. I also love the fact that he just decided to grab more rebounds this season, so he seems like a guy who's always about improving his game. And if Avery Bradley can build on what he started this season before the injury, I mean, who knows? Maybe if his scoring doesn't go up, maybe his playmaking will increase. So he'll be a guy who averages like 16 points, grabs 6 rebounds, and also gets like 4 assists a game, on top of being one of the best defensive players in the NBA. I mean, Bradley could be one of the most all-around players in the league, and I think there's a real possibility that his playmaking is going to take a jump next season. He already showed signs this year of someone who can do some stuff off the dribble before he was injured. He's already willing to improve on his rebounding. I think the next step for Bradley could be a real thing with his playmaking as well as creating abilities. Now, I don't want people's feelings to get hurt, so let's name some honorable mentions. Otto Porter's creating ability could take a step up. I think with Ben Simmons back, Robert Covington could actually get some open looks. Willie Hernangómez is going to have his first real full season as a Knicks starter. I'm excited to see what happens. Malcolm Brogdon was NBA ready, and he was super efficient. Hopefully he just builds on that. And Schroeder may have some work to do on his three-point shooting and drawing fouls, but he could take the next step. Next, we're going to talk about Norman Powell, and this is the most expert analysis I can ever provide on a player. Norman Powell just does stuff. And I don't think he has like one explicit ability that's just like through the roof crazy, but he's a solid all-around player. Defensively, he's shown an ability to defend point guards, shooting guards. He's not the best when it comes to small forwards, and the footage isn't helping because I'm having him defend Paul George, but whatever, we're going to roll with it anyway. But he's also seemed like a guy who can be a part of an offense, not someone you really run offense through, but, you know, a guy who can set some screens, receive a handoff, pass, and then take one dribble to the basket where he can finish kind of okay. But he can also be a three-point shooter, and he always knows how to make the right pass. And the big reason why I think Powell could have the big season next year for the Toronto Raptors is Dwayne Casey, if it's Dwayne Casey as the head coach, will just freaking play him. His first season, he played 14 minutes a game. This season, he played 18 minutes a game. Both are complete crimes, as he should be the first guy off of Toronto's bench. But then in the playoffs, he started playing 25-plus minutes a game, and my desire for Dwayne Casey to be fired, rhyming accidentally, was diminished just a little bit. I do think he's still not the right head coach for where the Raptors are at this moment, even though I think he's done a decent job of building them up. Isn't it funny how every single time there's a Raptors anything in a video, I have to turn it back to firing Dwayne Casey? Norman Powell's good, man. Effective two-way player, plays within himself, athletic, can jet up and down the floor. He's just got to get the minutes. And I think next season he finally will. I'm praying that he finally will. Or just my Celtics can trade for him or something. Norman Powell, I'm rooting for you, man. Now we can talk about Miles Turner, who, if I can be honest, I think people crowned him a little too quickly this season. You know, people were excited with some of the offseason moves the Pacers made, and I was like, you know, he's a second-year player, guys. Let's not just include him into the Pacers becoming one of the best teams in the NBA story. But what was really intriguing about his second season was his improvement in pretty much all areas. His point production went up, his rebounds increased, he became a legit three-point shooter. Although he only took about one a game, I do like the signs that he's showing, and given that how awesome of a mid-range and inside scorer he already is, I just think his offensive game is going to expand, and in his third season, we're going to really see Miles Turner take off. But also, defensively, he's up to 2 blocks a game right now, and I wouldn't say he's like super athletic for a big dude, but he does move around the floor enough to where he can be pretty effective on that side of the floor combined with his shot blocking abilities. So I think the Pacers could be having a third year player who really goes to the next level as a 3-point shooter, a role guy, scoring in the post somewhat, and then someone who can just be pretty effective on the defensive side of the floor. Now the big question is going to be what happens with Paul George. I mean, if Paul George is not there, then Turner's production is definitely going to increase, but the Pacers are not going to win that many games. If Paul George is still there, then I could see him maybe not taking a huge leap, maybe up to like 17 or 18 points a game, but his impact just like goes through the roof. There's going to be a big improvement for him next season, in my opinion, regardless. And then finally, Aaron Gordon, and I'm going to try to make this not sound like it's just my Magic My GM series. Aaron Gordon was used incorrectly for the majority of the season because Serge Ibaka was the starting power forward for these guys, and Frank Vogel decided to put Aaron Gordon at the small forward position, which means he was just chilling around the three-point line all the time. They traded away Ibaka, Gordon took over the power forward spot, suddenly he's able to cut to the rim way more effectively, and as well as more often. He shoots around 65% plus at the rim, so he's good down there, setting screens, getting pick and rolls, finishing alley-oops. But what's also kind of intriguing is how he's able to create his own shot. Like, he's very willing to go one-on-one with opposing NBA wing players and actually have some success against them. I actually saw a clip where he hit like a pull-up mid-range jumper, and I was like, why the hell are you shooting that? But then it actually kind of worked. He's showing a lot of improvement since Ibaka was gone. His point production has definitely increased. I wish his playmaking was a little better than what it was, but I mean, what you gonna do? If he's gonna put up some points, then I guess that's still a good thing overall. Now, I should say, I do still have questions about how consistent of a shooter he can really be over the stretch of an entire season, but I do still think he can have a big year next year for the Magic just because there's nobody in his way at this point. It's going to be his fourth season. He finishes really well around the rim. He shows good ball handling abilities for a power forward. He has some willingness to attack one-on-one. Who knows how effective that will really be for an 82-game stretch. But still, the potential is super high for him. And I think next season we're really going to see that start to show just because He's not going to be playing the small forward position. He's going to be around the rim, able to grab rebounds, play defense. And I feel like I've been saying this for like 3 years at this point, so I look forward to it hopefully happening.